আসসালামু আলাইকুম ওয়ারাহমাতুল্লাহি ওয়াবারাকাতু। বিসমিল্লাহির রহমানির রহিম। আলহামদুলিল্লাহি রাব্বিল আলামিন, ওয়াসসালাতু ওয়াসসালামু আলা রাসূলিহি মুহাম্মদ ওয়া আলা আলিহি ওয়া আসহাবিহি আজমাইন। উই প্রেজ আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা, উই সেন্ড ব্লেসিংস এন্ড স্যালুটেশনস আপন দ্য প্রফেট মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম, his entire household, his companions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us the salah we've just fulfilled, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us be such that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses us for the betterment of Islam and for the spread of Islam and for the spread of peace and for the spread of unity. Ameen. If you look at Islam, we all know that Islam is a religion of peace. We know the Shahada, we testify there is none worthy of worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger, the best of creation, the most noble of all the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So definitely we know and we agree that Islam is a religion of peace. We all agree that Islam is a religion of peace. So for each and every single Muslim, be them brother or sister, they should see themselves as an agent or agents for the promotion of peace, agents for the promotion of peace, for the promotion of unity, for the promotion of love, for the promotion of justice, for the promotion of honesty, for the promotion of truthfulness, for the promotion of kindness, for the promotion of everything that is good. For indeed, Islam is a religion that is all about goodness. Any type of good that you think is there or you see is there, you should always think of a possible way that you would be a person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would use in order to spread that good. So today across the globe, alhamdulillah, we have peace to some extent. At the same time, there is conflict in so many places, even within the Muslim communities as well. But then there is a problem sometimes that we have. It is normal, it is in the nature of humans to always, when they see something wrong, they would want to start saying, who is the person who is causing this thing? Who is the person who has done that thing? So it is in our nature that we, whenever something happens, we just want to remove ourselves from that thing and look for another person who is supposed to be at fault for that particular thing. Well, as Muslims, it would be very good of us, as Muslim brothers and sisters and everyone else, that we always check ourselves as well. Is there any way I can improve? Is there any way I can become better? Is there anything I am doing that is wrong? If there is, then we should be improving ourselves. And definitely there is, because we all make mistakes. So if we begin to think from this angle to say, I also make mistakes, so I also need to improve myself, then there would be a great change. But the problem that is there always, any small thing that happens, it is always one brother or one sister. What about myself? What about yourselves? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change the condition of a nation until and unless they change themselves. If we want change, we have to be the cause of that change. If we want to see better community, better things happening, we ourselves need to change. Are you honest? Ask yourself. Are you kind? Ask yourself. Are you truthful? Ask yourself. Are you humble? Ask yourself. Do you have pride? Ask yourself. If you have pride, you need to do away with that pride. You have to look at the whole character and conduct that you have. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, the best from among you are those who have the best character and conduct. خياركم أحسنكم أخلاقا. The best from among you are those who have the best character and conduct. How should the character of a Muslim be like? It is always meant to be exceptional. The character of a Muslim is always meant to be exceptional, meant to be different from the character of the other people. That is who a Muslim is supposed to be like. If you look at another hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he was asked two things that take someone to paradise, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Taqwallahi wa husnul khuluqi. The consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or sometimes we translate that to say the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second one is the character and conduct. When you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know you have a Lord who sees everything you do. You see, like we say, this life is just like a clock. It starts off from where it starts off. It ticks, ticks and ticks. When it goes round the clock, your time is up, and then the angels come to take your soul away. So it is left, how did you spend that time you had? So if you are a Muslim or a person who always thinks, I have a Lord who is always seeing me, I would keep on trying my best to make sure I am a better person, because I know I have a short time here. I have an account of rewards, account of good deeds. I want the account to be filled up with so much good deeds that if I come on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be pleased with me, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would grant me Jannah as a result. But sadly today, a lot of us, the character and conduct is not very good. And we don't sit and think, is there anything wrong that I should improve on? But really, if all of us all together would sit and start thinking of the bad things we do and start eradicating them one after the other, then by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would see the better nation or the better community we are all asking for. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Taqwallahi wa husnul khuluqi. You develop your link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taqwallahi an taj'ala baynaka wa bayna adhabillahi wikaya. The consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to put a barrier between you and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An taj'ala baynaka wa bayna adhabillahi wikaya. You should put barrier between you, yourself, and the punishment of Allah. Don't do anything that would bring about the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is taqwallah. And then we said husnul khuluq, the character and conduct. How should it be like? It should be exceptional. When people see you, they should know, yes, really Islam is a religion of peace, a religion of goodness. It is also from among the qualities of a Muslim that when someone does something wrong, we don't become agents of spreading that wrong they did. You cannot become an agent of spreading the wrong someone did. As Muslims, we want to conceal the weakness of our brothers and sisters. The problem we have, every small thing, we want the whole world to know what the brother or the sister did. This is something we need to improve as well. Man satara musliman, satarahu Allahu fi dunya wal akhirah. Whoever shields or hides the misdeed of a Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would do the same for that person, Allah would hide your misdeed, shield your misdeed in this world as well as the next. But sadly, every small thing, we want the whole world to see, wow, look at what the brother did, or look at what the sister did, and it is on every social networking platform, and it is, they call it what is trending, or it has gone viral, and people are throwing dirty comments about the brother or the sister. What have you achieved? Is this how we want to bring up a better nation? Subhanallah. You spread, you make everyone know the wrong that brother or sister did. You have not helped them because you never spoke to them. You've done nothing in terms of ensuring that that brother or sister becomes a better person. So what have you done? Rather, you make them hate themselves the more and perhaps want to do something that is even worse than what they had done already. So no change has come. That is why before we do anything, we always think. We are supposed to be thinking. We need to as well respect one and all, irrespective of the dressing of the person, irrespective of how they look, or where they come from, or the race. Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Oh people, indeed, we have created you, made you from the male and female, and we have put you into tribes and nations so that you can interact with one another. So that you can interact with one another. لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Indeed, the most noble in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from among you is the most righteous. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is acquainted with what you do. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about interaction. Well, if you have to interact with people, then it has to be done in a beautiful way. Even through your speech, people can get inspired and they would perhaps want to accept Islam. They would perhaps want to accept Islam by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just through your speech. Have you made it your habit when you see people, you greet them. You say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Or you can just say, Assalamu alaikum. Or Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Or Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, when you are being greeted with the Islamic greeting, you should respond firstly with that which is better than what you were greeted with. If not, reply with something that is similar to what you were greeted with. So if I tell you, Assalamu alaikum, you're supposed to say, Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah, or Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. If I say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, you're supposed to say, Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And if I say, All, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, then, mashallah, you say, Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And you should be happy doing it, not Assalamu alaikum wa alaikum assalam. As though you are fighting, no. Smile, look at the brother, shake them and smile. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah, my brother. You do things for the sake of Allah, really. You would see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would increase the love among all of us. Among all of us. Afshu salama baynakum. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, spread the Islamic greeting among yourselves. It would bring about love, harmony, respect. Imagine you enter a place, for example, let's say this masjid, someone enters here, a brother, and as soon as he enters, everyone was frowning. Only one brother greeted him, and he smiled and greeted him. Then when the brother came, he sat, and then he wants something, maybe an explanation or something to ask. If he gets up, the first person he would meet to talk to would be the brother that greeted him when he came in, because no one else greeted him. So he is now happier with the brother because he has seen the love or the kindness in that brother, that when he came inside the masjid, he was the only one that greeted him. Try it. Go somewhere. Everyone is not looking at you. Only one brother came. Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum salam. What are you doing here? You want to do X, Y, and Z? Then you go. And then maybe later on you want some explanation. When you come, you would automatically search for that first brother, because you saw he was kind to you when you came. Everyone else was frowning, while the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, smiling at the face of your brother is an act of charity. It also goes a long way. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us an understanding. Because really, Islam is a religion of peace only if we sit and we look. If you look at the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are so many things that we can practice to bring about change, that we are always saying, we want change, we want change, we want change. We can bring about this change by ourselves, by improving and making sure that we become better people, wallahi. But we have to try. We cannot just sit and say the country is in a mess or everything is going wrong, so it is the fault of the president, for example, or the fault of the person ruling the place. Yes, everyone makes mistakes. Perhaps the person ruling the state or country or city, they may have certain things they need to improve upon. But what about yourselves that are being ruled? It's a 50-50. Or should I say, everyone has their role to play. The person ruling would play his own role, and those that are following the person ruling, they also have to play their role. Imagine the person ruling moving in one direction, those following moving in another direction, and you want to get to the same place, and only one road, for example, can take you to that one place, then there's a problem. Subhanallah. So that's why we all together need to improve ourselves. Let's be kind, let's be good to those we stay with. The neighbors, our neighbors, let's be kind to them. The people we see on the street, let's be kind to them. Those you meet at your workplace, be kind to them. And one thing about kindness, we should never ever think that kindness is only meant for the Muslims. Meaning, I am a Muslim, so I would be kind only to another Muslim. That is wrong. Kindness is for one and all. Because if you really love Islam, then you would want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use you to bring people to Islam. To bring people to Islam. So if you are only going to be kind to fellow Muslims, then there is a problem. Your love is not genuine. If it is genuine, you would be kind and good to everyone. And don't belittle people because of how they look. Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum. The most noble in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most righteous. Never mind, people can call you names and say whatever because you are trying to improve yourself. So they say you are an extremist, or you think you are the only pious one. Allow them to say whatever they want to say. By the way, you are not doing it for them. You are doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you want to improve your link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah la yanzuru ila suwarikum wala ila ajisamikum walakin yanzuru ila qulubikum wa amalikum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't look at the shapes or the wealth, but rather he looks at the hearts and the deeds. So allow people to say whatever they want to say. You see, sometimes, not even sometimes, every time, a lot of the times, even if it is good thing you do, no bad here, they still want to say something negative. So just allow them. Even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was called names, he was called so many things, but that never ever stopped him from continuing the good. We learn great lessons from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even if someone was wrong, or a people were wrong, he can still forgive. If you look at the story of what happened in Ta'if with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had the chance to say what he wanted to be done with the people. But he said, Allahumma hdi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lamun. Oh Allah, guide my people, for they don't know. Subhanallah. Imagine if it was someone else. Someone does something wrong to you. Very wrong. Something very, very bad. Then the president calls you and tells you, come, you tell us what you want to be done with this person and it will be done. Would you say, forgive me that person? Only few people can say that. Only few, perhaps. He calls you, tells you, say whatever you want, it shall be done with this person. He would probably say, you need to seize X, Y, and Z. You need to take him to this cell for so years and do X, Y, and Z. You may even make a list of how you want the punishment to be like. But the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been sent as a mercy. فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَظًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is because of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you were lenient towards them. You were soft, calm, kind, and lenient towards them. If you were harsh and hard-hearted, they would have dispersed. They would have run away from around you. They wouldn't stay. So being merciful, being good, is something that is very, very great. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us iman, to grant us the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to grant us the ability to always be focused upon the right things before time clocks, before the angel comes to take the soul away. We don't want to be like those who would say, oh Allah, I wish I can return back to the earth so that فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ, so that I can give out charity, spend for the sake of Allah, and so that I can be from among the pious ones. Surah Al-Munafiqun.
وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقَ.
فَأَصَّدَّقَ, what's the ending part of the verse?
فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ,
and spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before death comes to any one of you. Before death comes to any one of you and you say, oh, I wish I can be returned back to the earth so that I can spend for the sake of Allah and so that I can be from among the pious ones, the righteous ones. We don't want to regret when it is too late. We want to utilize our time right now so that we would be building. We would be building our akhirah. You can't come to the earth, waste time, building here and there is ruined. Rather, you build here in a good way, in a way that through building here, you are building there. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the change we are seeking for. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase the love we have for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless each and every single one of us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us every form of goodness. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azaban nar. Allahumma inna nas'aluka. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us jannatul firdaus. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma rabbana wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.